Welcome to the next episode of Distance Learning with the Bakersfield Symphony. Today we're going to take a look at the next movement in Modest Mussorgsky's Pictures at an Exhibition entitled Samuel Goldenberg and Schmuyle. As you may know by now, each movement is based on a piece of artwork by Mussorgsky's friend, Victor Hartmann. Well, this particular movement is based on two pieces of artwork, and both of them have survived for us to look at today because they actually belonged to Mussorgsky himself. One is a portrait of a wealthy Jewish man, whom Mussorgsky has dubbed Samuel Goldenberg, and the other is a poor Jewish beggar in the streets of a Jewish ghetto in Sandomierz, Poland, whom Mussorgsky called Schmuyle. Mussorgsky represents both of these persons very distinctly in the music. You may have noticed by now that Mussorgsky puts a lot of his own emotional energy and interpretation into his music. The paintings serve as a starting point, and Mussorgsky's imagination takes him the rest of the way. In this case, it's no different. He creates a theme for each of our two characters for this movement, and they could not be more different from each other. We'll listen to each theme individually first, get something to write with, and while you're listening, write down what you think the character of the person is like, based on their theme. Feel free to pause the video if you need more time. We'll listen to Samuel Goldenberg's theme first. We already know that Samuel Goldenberg is a wealthy man, but I think we can say with certainty, based on the character of the music, that he's not kind-hearted and philanthropic. No, the music is strong and menacing. It speaks to me of a man who is very proud, who looks down on anyone he considers beneath him, a man who is concerned only with himself and does not have compassion for others. Let's contrast this picture with that of Schmuyle, the poor beggar on the streets of the Jewish ghetto. The painting itself portrays a very different kind of man. Let's see what the music has to tell us about his character. Go ahead and write down what you think the music tells us about him as you're listening. The image this calls to my mind is that of trembling supplication. The melody here is a series of triplet rhythms high up in the trumpet's range, repetitive and pleading. The man in the painting is reminiscent of many homeless men you may have seen. He's seated on the street next to a bag of belongings, bushy hair and beard, eyes downcast. The music, I think, portrays him begging as people walk by. Please, do you have any change? Please, whatever you have, please. As the music continues, both of these themes are put together. You'll hear Schmuyle's theme in the trumpet, with Samuel Goldenberg's theme beneath it in the low strings. Let's listen. imagine happening here is Schmuyle asking Samuel Goldenberg for money, as he's been asking others, but Goldenberg seems just as proud and menacing as ever, not exactly the charitable type. In the conclusion of the movement, Goldenberg has the last word. Let's listen. What do you think the music is showing? Does Goldenberg throw out a few pieces of spare change? Does he have a change of heart? Or does he dismiss poor Schmuyle, chastising him for taking up space on the street? I have my own opinion of what the music portrays of the interaction, but I'm not going to tell you my opinion this time. Let's listen to the movement as a whole, and I'd like you to come up with your own conclusions about what Mussorgsky is telling us about the ending of this interaction. So what do you think Goldenberg's response to Schmuyle was? Please feel free to comment on the YouTube video with your answers. I'd love to hear them. In the meantime, I have some follow-up questions and activities for you. 1. Describe the interaction between Samuel Goldenberg and Schmuyle, following the pattern of theme appearances in the music. You can do this in prose, as though writing a short story, or in the form of a script. 2. The painting of Schmuyle was based in a Jewish ghetto in Sandomierz, Poland. Do a Google search for the city and see if you can find some basic information and pictures. Imagine the interaction between the characters taking place on those city streets. You can either A. write a summary of the information you found, or B. draw a picture of the two characters interacting on a street corner, using pictures of real-life Sandomierz as the basis for your setting. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to check back for more video lessons.